kitchen musical is one word.
Gastronomy musical.
Yummy.
Exciting.
Craziness.
Romance.
OMG. Awesome.
Just one word wouldn't cut it, actually.
The Kitchen Musical is a genre-busting TV series which fuses food, music, dance, drama into what I call a TV musical series.
I need a better selection.
People don't care about $1,000 wines and tiny-ass portions.
I've always liked all those elements. And then everything come together and I say, let's do something that fuses the food, music, dance, drama element all into one. The story is about how a rich girl, her name is Madeleine Avalon.
Maddie, you're a sous chef, right?
Yes.
What does it mean?
Under the chef.
Exactly.
Very talented, graduate from good cooking school or chef school. You know, instead of going to all the big names in the restaurant world, she comes back home to her own family's restaurant, which is called the Avalon. The Avalon is run by a very strict kind of old school head chef called Alex Marcus. And therefore, you know, sparks fly.
Why don't you do us a favor and leave?
Oh, I play Maddie Avalon. She owns the restaurant, so I'm very rich. And her mom was a chef, so there's a little bit of that. And I guess she just wants to find her own mark in the culinary world.
You know, this night can make or break it for the Avalon.
We're talking about really cleverly written scripts with great use of irony, great use of character development, but it's a musical.
The musical element would be an expression of our subconscious. It's a device wherein the audience can see that, oh, this is what they're feeling right now and this is what they want to do right now, but they can't. So we break into song.
I play Alex Marcus and he's a mean, lean cooking machine.
Okay, listen up for a minute. Gather round.
I get to be hard on everyone in the kitchen, and Alex, he's a bit neurotic, and of course I have some neuroses of my own, but I'm definitely not like him.
I'm Rosemary Vandenbroek, and I play Selena Argon on The Kitchen Musical.
I expect all my staff to know how a dish is prepared and which wine it best complement them.
She's like high-ranking sommelier. She's very confident, sexy.
Hello, boys.
She likes to state her opinion freely. It's fun playing her character because I get to say things that I wouldn't normally say.
This is not your job. Get back to your station.
Come on, she's hurt.
You're fired.
You're fired.
You're fired. You got it?
You can't fire Leslie.
She sticks out like a cold sore.
Not a good enough reason.
Mr. Avalon was right about you.
This is not about me. This is about Denise, the girl you hired.
My name is Arthur Acuna. I play Harry Shaw in The Kitchen Musical.
Go easy on her, Alex. You know she idolizes you.
Harry.
Harry Shaw was a former executive chef who fell from grace because of alcohol. And he's got a lot of personal conflicts and conflicts with the outside world in general. So he's just a guy trying to swim through very heavy water to redeem himself. Every role is a challenge to me. When I attack character, for example, I'm not attacking it like I have to turn into a totally different person. No, I'm looking at what would I be in a situation like that. That, to me, is character.
What's great about The Kitchen Musical is it gives a lot of value to everyday life because it's teaching you about food and wine. It's perfect. I think really a lot of people will enjoy that. And we have a little dessert at the end, too.
Gâteau l'opéra. It's a French dessert made with layers of almond sponge cake.
You get to learn the recipes of every dish that's been set up.
Yeah. I won't let you down. I will not give you up. Gotta have some faith in the sound. It's a one.
I had to do a 2-day boot camp where we were doing lots of chopping. What was interesting was then everybody started to fall into very a natural sort of hierarchy, and immediately you started to see the team. You know, we saw all these characters start popping out during that boot camp, and it was very cool.
The same thing here. What we do is you cut fish always in an angle.
We had a chef Horst with us from Republic Police Culinary Institute.
He's amazing, and he really drilled it into us how a chef would in a kitchen, you know, he's riding you hard, you've got to get the dish out, you've got to be under pressure all the time. But you can't panic, that's the thing. And I think that was the hardest part for me, especially when someone's yelling at me, I tend to go into that panic mode where I don't know what to do. And he goes, no, just focus on what you're doing, and it's fine.
Being a vegetarian, I have very limited experience cooking meat. But the producers were actually cool enough and smart enough to get us in with a great chef who taught us some real basic rules about the kitchen. They're just prepared every day to take us through step-by-step processes to make us not look foolish.
Very good.
I remember our chef Horst telling us, this food is $100 food, you know? You have to take care of it. It has to be like a little important thing to you, you know, you have to touch it, you have to really nurture it. So when I go to different restaurants, and I appreciate it when they have those clear walls where you can actually see the chef, so I really look at them, I really notice how they work, they just really go. So I think that, I put that in the kitchen, so while I sing or I dance, I still have to be fast with my work, I have to be natural.
One of the main reasons why I chose Republic Polytechnic's location for this set is because the architecture is beautiful, landscaping is beautiful. You've got this kind of reflecting pool.
Typically, we send our students out to industry, so this really was a boon to us. You know, this was a serendipity for us. This is exactly the sort of thing we train our students for, to create content for the region and beyond.
My interest is to bring the industry to the students. I've always wanted to make sure that the next group of people joining the industry need to see how production can be done. And I like what Republic Poly is doing. You know, you've got a fully functioning kitchen. You have school technology and arts, you got the production people, you got studios, you have the kitchen, you have expertise of the hospitality people. So all that coming together very nicely.
Our new media students have been creating the Facebook and the Twitter buzz for this production. You know, they've been managing the interaction with fans, they've been loading behind the scenes clips to attract, you know, more eyeballs to the production. Essentially, they're really milking the viral potential of this production via social networks.
The Kitchen Musical is a sweet, hot, sexy mess.
Oh dear, yes, what he said.
I won't let you down, I will not give you up. Gotta have some faith in the sound, it's the one good thing that I've got.
Well, first I was expecting him to be there in the studio, like in a regular recording studio, so when I was like, hey Gerard, where are you? Hi Christian. There's like a delay. Why is there a delay? Because he's in the Philippines and we're in Singapore and it's connected through Wi-Fi.
Working with Gerard Salonga, who was the disembodied voice guiding you through the whole thing, was actually a trip.
I met Cheek, the director, and he started telling me about this project. It's very ambitious, very big in scale, and everything turned out great, and now here I am working on the Kitchen Musical and I'm having a blast.
He's very specific. You know, he clues you in where you could go and this and that, and after all that, he would tell you that, okay, do one more and just let go.
5, 6, 7, 8. I just hope you understand.
Don't tell the cold tsunami make the man.
All we have to do now.
He's a musical genius, and I love his take on a lot of the songs. They are interpretations. Sometimes they're really far from what the original is, so I find that really interesting.
The challenge which I'm really enjoying right now is the breadth of the styles that I have to cover musically. It's a good test of my versatility, and so far so good. I've not run into anything that I can't do.
The Kitchen Musical is a bit more old school, like a homage to a lot of things that we've seen past before, and doing it in a new sense.
The music. It has to be a song that people listen to and go, oh my God, that is so cool, it reminds me of so many things. So So it has to be a fairly popular song. But what I like to do with Gerard, whenever we can, is to put a twist to it. Even if it's a direct cover, there is a twist to it. I mean, we're doing a lot. We're rearranging it, we're re-recording it. You know, when you listen to the song, it could be a completely different song. So one song in particular is Unwell.
All day, staring at the ceiling, making friends with shadows on my wall. All night, hearing voices telling me that I should get some sleep.
The way he rearranged it is just very, very cool. It starts off and you don't even know that it is Unwell. So it's just something refreshing but yet recognizable. And then with Jason Coleman, the dance and the movement, I said, this is a song. I see this, you know, in a circular movement or a steady cam, and it's all kind of dark and people come in and out of light. And he takes that idea and he will then choreograph a whole movement or dance around that.
I've been a dancer my whole life. I've been a dancer since I was 4 years old. I spent 15, 20 years working as a professional dancer, but I'm not into dancing. I think that all steps need to have a narrative base and a purpose for happening. So for me, what's the difference between dancing and aerobics? Feeling and story. What's the difference between dancing and gymnastics? Feeling and story. So all of my work is always very narratively driven. And I think that then people don't just watch the work. What they do then is the steps and what we're doing, they then have the ability to feel the work. And if you're making people feel, you're evoking an emotion from them. And that's what I believe our job is, to evoke emotion from people through what we're giving them. 'Cause I gotta have faith.
I gotta have faith. I'm not a natural dancer. But I do my best, so I am just very glad that the whole cast really supports each other, helps each other out. So if sometimes it takes one guy to get the dance in like 2 minutes, I get it in like 2 weeks. So I gotta like really work on it.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
But thanks to Jason Coleman, he's making it so easy for us. He's so encouraging, so constructive in the way he handles us, that you will really be lifted up when you learn the dance.
There's a fast turnaround of songs, so we're trying to learn stuff sometimes as you're going into the studio. It's interesting what comes up, like a song that you would usually hear a song go, okay, that's what the song's about, and then suddenly it becomes about something else. I'm on that HD flat, this beat go boom, boom, bap. I'm a beast when you turn me on, into the future Cybertron. Harder, faster, better, stronger, sexy ladies, extra longer, 'cause we gotta beat that bounce, we gotta beat that pound. The dance sequences are really like full on, and also you're learning like 2-3 dances a week for the next episode, so you're shooting and then after you're rehearsing, learning the dance, learning your lines, learning the songs, and all for the next week. And this is within the week when you're already shooting. So
well, as you can see, I'm a dancer by nature.
Yes.
I have very nice, nimble bones and structure. And they make me dance a lot, so I think that's my strength. No, it's really, really fun lah. It's working with wonderful choreographers, a wonderful director. Your turn. am a dancer. In my heart, I know that I am, even though my body doesn't believe it.
Not all of the cast in the Kitchen Musical come with a dance background, but I haven't limited the steps in any way in regards to that.
You don't work on your suit.
Space would be the biggest issue that I have here. The size of the kitchen particularly is the hardest thing for me, but you know, I walk on the sunny side of the street, so I don't see problems as problems. I see them as small challenges to get past, and I know the parameters that I'm making it for, and so I'm now choreographing for the shots and for the limited space that we've got. I've also tried to use some of the things in the kitchen. I've used all of the props and all the circumstances and the scenes that we have within the kitchen, the restaurant, to enhance the choreography rather than to challenge it.
Myx the Joker, I'm the makeup consultant. The Makeup Forever is the best product for HD, especially the foundation, the powders. These products are really special because when you play with on the skin, they became skin on skin.
Your main course, Mr. Masters, a wreck of land.
Food has always been a kind of a main theme in a lot of my storytelling.
This is a classic cassoulet cooked with an assortment of pinto, cannelli and white beans with pork shoulder merguez, a spicy mutton sausage. And this is baked in the liquid of peeled tomatoes.
Food, music, dance and song. It's kind of hard to explain and people really have to see it to go, oh. It also fuses what I call my creative journey in the last 10 years or so. And now it's all kind of fuses together into this. Everything comes together at the right time, at the same time.
Now we present food in a magical way, in an entertaining way. We are able to present this new culture that's going around in this generation about how we are so in love with food. This is my favorite dish, medium rare.
You call that a medium? You'll never make it a chef.
That's good.
Yeah? Stay in character.
Oui, chef.
Where'd you go to culinary school? McDonald's?
Le cordon bleu, chef.
Le cordon bull crap? That looks like my granny's toast.
None of us have ever heard of each other. So there's no ego, there's no star. Carrying on, there's none of that. It's just a bunch of really talented people being brought together into this fabulous place that is Singapore to make one of the cutest and most ironic and fun musicals that's been made in television for years and years. It's a really great project to be a part of.
Now love don't come easy, but I keep on waiting, anticipating.
I feel very blessed to be like put into this new family that we've created.
I have different relationships with everybody.
That's what you get, that's what you get.
The frame is okay?
No.
We really make time for everyone to hang out, chill with each other, get to know each other. So it's a good relationship. I'm sure everyone will say this.
Okay, thanks guys. Let's break for lunch. No!
Everyone is just so nice. So it's slowly becoming a family.
I think if I ever had a twin brother, that'd be him. Easy. He's like the male version of me.
Who's my best friend? Everyone's my best friend.
I would hope that people sort of accept us for our own identity. I mean, when people see it, they, you know, it'll be very quickly noticed for its own flavour. No pun intended. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Guys, push! Okay, move it. Full place.
No.
More phlegm. Okay.
Wait, ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Action.
The Kitchen Musical.
Dadating na sa Philippines. Abangan.
Mabuhay.
What? You know more than that. Sorry. Wait a minute. Okay.
The Kitchen Musical.
Coming to a channel near you.
Make a pout.
Kitchen Musical. New episodes Mondays, 8/7 Central on Myx TV.